Hi everyone, Tony for Lightwave Salvation here. Sorry it's been a while. Obviously I've been really busy creating new contents for marketing and training for Lightwave Digital. So I'm going to make a quick tutorial today, and it's basically because I came across a plugin that I used to use years ago called Jetto Filter, and it smooths corners for you. And I used to use it quite a lot, and I just forgot about it. I think because as you change and upgrade Lightwave software, and I forgot to transfer it over, and I've just found it in a folder, and so I just want to show you what it does. And I can't find it on the internet anymore, but I've got it for PC, sorry, and I'll put a link to my Dropbox so you can have a go at it as well. So let's just start by making a basic cube. In fact, a flat, we'll do a flat plane like this. So it could be a flat plane like this, or it could be a flat vector shape. So we're talking about flat shapes like this, 2D flat shapes, before you extrude them. But let's imagine I wanted, let's say, this corner and this corner smoothed in some way. It could be in different ways, but anyway, if you don't know how to actually add a plugin, so under utilities, you can just go add plugin and choose it and add it. And when it adds it under additional. So I'll go down and it's called Jetto Filter V5.1.5. So I click it and it does this. So it's currently on maximum. So if I unclick it, let's just put 0 100 millimeters. So basically you've got a radius, which is the radius of the corner, and how many segments you want in that corner, so you can reduce it down if you want. Look. Like so, it's such a simple little cool little plugin. I really like it. But yeah, you can decide on how you want it. It dead easily make a leaf, weren't you thinking like that? But obviously click maximum and it'll show you maximum like so. But it's as easy as that. So if I press OK and spacebar, the only thing it does is it leaves the original point. So if you select and just press delete, they'll get rid of it. But that's just on a basic like shape. So let's do another one. Let's use the pen tool, and I'm just going to randomly draw out with a pen tool of just a random shape like that. Okay, so Here's a random shape, but let's say certain parts, or let's say I wanted these corner bits to be rounded, okay, or concaved even. So let's go to utilities. You can go and add it to one of your, so you might want to add it to, let's say, I'd probably add it to multiply underneath bevel or something like that, you know, if you wanted to. But let's go back to it as well. Let's bring it down and let's make it so these edges are nice and curved like so. You can obviously decide on how many bits again you want, or you can click maximum like so. But I'm just going to bring it in so I've got a nice smooth edge like that. Press OK again. I think because it's old, before I don't remember it leaving the original point, but it's not hard to delete them. I could say okay, I want these two edges as well. So let's make them a bit bigger, like that. Okay, let's again delete those. And I could say, oh, here's my shape I need, no idea what it is. And then let's go to multiply thicken, let's just thicken it up. And then we've got the kind of, you've got the shape here then, like so. So it is pretty cool. One more and then that's it really. It's as easy as that, it's not hard. Let's just do, let's do a disc like so, and let's select I'm going to select every other point. There used to be a plugin to do this as well, where it loops and it will miss every other point. Don't remember what that is called. If anyone remembers, let me know, put it in the description. And then let's just use maybe the size tool. Let's bring it out to that, and again let's go into utilities. Let's add it, it'll make it nice and smooth like this, kind of like a flower really. And let's say, I don't know, I'm happy with that. delete the other points, and then what you've got is you've got your little shape here, like so. I suppose, what else could you do with this? I suppose you could select it, go multiply, more. Let's make a pole. Let's bring that up in the air. No idea what this shape is, but what you've got is a random shape that if somebody says make me that, I'd have to really think, how am I going to make that? Do you know what I mean? Hollow in the bottom, so you could fit, you could like thicken it again, and then you've got this kind of shape as well. But yeah, Joe Filter, just a little plugin that I came across that I used to use that I forgot about. I'll put it in the a link in the description, but yeah, hopefully it might help you out. I think it's quite cool, especially because it works in 2024. So yeah, thanks for listening. Please share, subscribe, go and check out Lightwave Salvation Facebook group.